In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit. You are listening to Daily Bread Devotions with Father Eustace Yamet, a Salesian of Don Bosco. Your word, Lord, is a lamp for my steps. Stay tuned.
This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me.
It is Monday, the 10th of October, 2022. 28th week in ordinary time, and participating in the proclamation of the Word of God for today are the following Daily Bread members. Shingirai Mutetwa from Harare, Zimbabwe, celebrating her birthday today, takes for us the first reading. Brother Calistus Donipu, belonging to the FIC Brothers, celebrating his birthday today from Accra, Ghana, takes for us the responsorio psalm. And proclaiming the gospel is Father Virgilius Kawama, a missionary of Africa working in Nairobi, Kenya, as he celebrates his birthday today. Let us pray. May your grace, O Lord, we pray, at all times go before us and follow after, and make us always determined to carry out good works. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
First reading. We are not children of the slave, but of the free woman. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians. Galatians 4 verses 22 to 24, 26 to 27, 31 to 5 verse 1. Brethren, it is written that Abraham had two sons, one by a slave and one by a free woman. But the son of the slave was born according to the flesh, the son of the free woman through promise. Now this is an allegory. These women are two covenants. One is from Mount Sinai, bearing children for slavery. She is Hagar. But the Jerusalem above is free, and she is our mother. For it is written, "Rejoice, O barren one who does not bear. Break forth and shout, you who are not with labor pains. For the desolate has more children than she who has a husband." So, brethren, we are not children of the slave, but of the free woman. For freedom Christ has set us free. Stand fast, therefore, and do not submit again to a yoke of slavery. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorio Psalm. Psalm 113, verse 1b to 2, 3 to 4, 5a, and 6 to 7.
And the response is taken from Psalm 113, verse 2.
And the response is, "May the name of the Lord be blessed forevermore."
May the name of the Lord be blessed forevermore.
Praise, O servants of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. May the name of the Lord be blessed, both now and forevermore.
May the name of the Lord be blessed forevermore.
From the rising of the sun to its setting, praise be the name of the Lord. High above all nations is the Lord. Above the heavens his glory.
May the name of the Lord be blessed forevermore.
Who is like the Lord our God, who lowers himself to look down upon heaven and earth. From the dust he lifts up the lowly, from the ash heap He raises the poor.
May the name of the Lord be blessed forevermore.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Luke 11, verses 29-32. At that time, when the crowds were increasing, Jesus began to say, "This generation is an evil generation. It seeks a sign, but no sign shall be given to it except the sign of Jonah. For as Jonah became a sign to the men of Nineveh, so will the Son of Man be to this generation. The Queen of the South will arise at the judgment with the men of this generation and condemn them. For she came from the ends of the earth to hear the wisdom of Solomon. And behold, something greater than Solomon is here. The men of Nineveh will arise at the judgment with this generation and condemn it. For they repented at the preaching of Jonah, and behold, something greater than Jonah is here." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We are back to the lessons we are drawing from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians. As I told you, this letter is a genuine letter written by Paul himself. And he understood very well the corruption that was taking place in the Galatian community because of the influence of others who came to teach the Galatians that they needed to follow the rituals, to follow all that the Jews follow for them to attain salvation. But Paul wanted to explain to them that actually, it is faith that is the most important, because salvation is initiated by God and then worked on by us, quite all right. And he wanted to stress, not overlooking anything else, not overlooking the role that rules and norms play in our salvation. But he wanted to stress, to make them understand that it is only through Jesus Christ that we find salvation. Not through following what came on Mount Sinai. And he takes the allegory here, comparing the children of the promise with the children of the flesh. That if your focus is only on the things that have to do with fulfilling norms, then you are mistaken. Now he brings out a point that is very important for us to understand here. It is about human origins and divine origins. He says, you see, if we want things to flow and to have blessings in our lives, we should not act according to the flesh. We should act according to the promise. Meaning, relying on God and not on human solutions. Because Abraham made a mistake in losing his patience. He found himself with Sarah going for human solutions. And sometimes we find ourselves helpless. We find ourselves in a situation where we don't see anything happening. And because we don't see anything happening, we decide to engage some human powers. We go to a witch doctor, seek for a solution to have a child. We engage everything that we think can help. But in the end, we are filled with regrets. The outcome is not the best. And in the end, we become enslaved to what we thought was going to liberate us. I've seen so many people who go for human solutions, and in the end, they start paying for what they thought was going to liberate them throughout their lives. Human solution, according to the flesh. Abraham was ashamed later when God answered, as he promised him when he was 75 that he would make him have a child. It took another 25 years for that child to be born. But anyway, the child was born. And anyway, the will of God was fulfilled. But you can go back to the book of Genesis and you will realize what consequences were born because of the human solution that Abraham found himself in. Wait for God. Be patient and he will act. And the result of waiting for God, relying on his promises, is the fact that what you get from there is freedom. What you get from there does not have any strings attached. No, if it is riches that you are looking for and you have been relying on the hand of God, you will have nothing to pay. You will have free riches. I tell you, Jesus is concerned about a generation that was looking for human solution. A generation that wanted something born of the flesh. They wanted only hand-to-mouth kind of miracles. Nothing to do with their faith. This generation is a wicked generation. It is looking for a sign. But I'm not going to give any sign. The only sign I will give to this generation is a sign of the prophet Jonah. What was that sign? It was a sign of repentance. Jonah repented. The people of Nineveh repented. And that sign that Jesus is going to give them is a sign that will come with a cross. He will die on that cross. And that cross will bring repentance to those who are able to change by the word of God that is preached to them. Christ suffering on the cross was a sign of bringing people to repentance, to transformation. And let us listen to the word in our lives with an attitude of transformation in our lives. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed Monday to you.
Thanks be to God.
This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me. And I your bed.